Hello.
Hello, Mary?
Yes.
Hi, this is Roy from the Homeowners Association.
Uh-huh.
And we've had several complaints about your house that you've been snoring too loud at night.
Yeah.
And well, it's not funny, actually, ma'am. It needs to stop. Like,
we're
maybe
not snoring. What does that mean? We haven't even been home.
Okay, so you say you're not snoring, but then you don't know what it means? How do you know you're not doing it then?
No, I guess I don't know what it means. I'm thinking snoring in bed.
Yeah, snoring in bed. So you need to, like, maybe shut your windows at night? Or if you're snoring so loud that you can be heard through the windows, you've just got to do something about it.
What is your name?
This is Roy. Maybe buy one of those big air filter things that goes across your face at night.
Pardon me, what is your last name?
Gerbel. Did one of you have sleep apnea?
No, we don't. And we have air conditioning, so our windows are closed.
Okay, well,
and we haven't been home for the last week.
Apparently you're snoring so loudly that we can hear you through the windows, and we're getting complaints.
Who is complaining?
Just neighbors, I guess, on either side of you. I'm not allowed. They're anonymous,
you know,
complaints.
My neighbors are not complaining because they're our very good friends.
Well, you know, they can still complain about things. Are you really fat? Is that why you snore so loud?
I don't know. I'm feeling like this is some practical joke.
Oh, it's no joke, ma'am. This could be
so
a.
So you're saying the Kolakowskis and the Gorskis are complaining?
Yeah. I'm not allowed to say that. We're supposed to keep the complaints anonymous. But it is people on either side of you, and you have to do something about it. Maybe go on a diet.
Okay. Well, we will. Thank you very much.
You're going to go on a diet. What are you going to do about it?
I will talk to our neighbors.
No, you don't need to talk to the neighbors. You need to stop snoring. We're not trying to cause conflict
okay,
with the neighbors.
We'll stop snoring then.
Well, how are you going to stop? What are you going to do? What steps are you going to take?
You know what, sir? I think you are totally out of line. What is your phone number? Because I'm going to right now go talk to Anthony, who is our neighbor. And I'm going to find out if you are really who you say you are, because I can't believe this. I think this is a practical joke, and I don't find it funny
at all. It's not a practical joke, and if you don't stop doing this, you're going to get a $35 a night fine for snoring too loud.
Okay. All right, well, tell me your number, Roy.
Sure, it's 248-390-9181.
Okay. All right, well, I will talk to our neighbors because they're our very good friends. We watch each other's house. I'm sure if they had a problem with us snoring, that they would tell us.
Well, maybe
and
they're...
Since we haven't been home, I don't think that this is really a legit call.
Maybe they're embarrassed
and
to tell you.
Pardon me?
Maybe they're embarrassed to tell you, and that's why they came to the Homeowners Association. That's what we're here for, stupid.
Did you just call me stupid?
Well, you're being really unreasonable.
I'm sorry. We don't snore. So first of all,
how do you know you don't snore if you're asleep?
How do I know if I don't snore if I'm asleep? This is just a ridiculous phone call. We haven't even been home, and I know that if my neighbors were complaining about something we've done, they would talk to us. Because that's the relationship we have.
Okay, unless they're embarrassed about it.
I feel like right now, sir, that you're the one who should be given a fine for giving us this kind of issue.
Cactus.
You gotta be crapping my balls.
Cactus.
How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
You think a tracer can stop me?
Hey everybody, this is RBCP. You're listening to the Snowplow Show for April 14th, 2016. Today's show is sponsored by Jeff, who is a Patreon supporter. Thank you, Jeff, for supporting us at patreon.com/phonelosers. I have important things to tell you today, such as the breaking news where prank callers are tricking Burger Kings into smashing their windows. About a billion people sent me this link through email. About a billion more posted it on the PLA Facebook group. Thank you, everybody who sent that in. That's been big news this week. I think multiple Burger Kings were involved, or maybe it just seems that way because so many people sent the story, but I think there were multiple Burger Kings, and there was a Jack in the Box. And what the prank call is people call into a fast food place, and they're like, hey, we're the fire department. There's a gas leak there or something. And the most sensible thing for you to do would be to break out all of the windows in the store. Don't run out into the parking lot and call 911 like a sensible person would. No, get into your car, get out a tire iron or something, and smash up all the windows in the store. That'll fix the gas leak. It makes perfect sense. I'm sure I would have fallen for that back when I worked in fast food places. So yeah, somebody is doing that again. Not that they ever really stopped. It's pretty much been an ongoing thing since about 2009, 2010. Nobody is really completely sure who's doing it. I used to blame it on PrankNet all the time, but then there were ones that were happening where people were getting in trouble for it, and it wasn't PrankNet, it was just other people doing it, I think. I don't think they were affiliated with PrankNet, but windows are being broken once again, and I'm going to have a link in the show notes to the story, and also I'm going to have a link in the show notes to a thing I found on Facebook where it actually has people kind of across the parking lot from a Burger King, and they're all recording on their cell phones as employees walk around the store and break out every single window. And that's kind of amusing to watch. Oh, yep, I'm looking at the story right now. I'm reading it, finally. This is the first time I've read it. But yeah, multiple Burger Kings involved. One in Minnesota, another in Oklahoma. Looks like there was one in California. And an employee named Ethan Grew is quoted in this article. He said, "It's nothing I ever came across, so I didn't know what to do. I guess I was a little scared. My other coworkers were doing it, so I just followed along." That sounds like something a Nazi would say. Everyone else is killing all these people, so I guess I should too. And Ethan has a unique last name. Let's see if he's on Facebook. See if he posted anything about this. There he is, Ethan in Minnesota. But he hasn't posted anything for over a year now, so I guess I just don't have access to see it. Damn it, I want to see some guy on Facebook's reaction to busting out all the windows. In other news, Michelle's Twitter is private now. You guys remember Michelle, right? The candle-cooing cunts lady? The gerbil harebrained something-something? She was a very interesting person, and I think a lot of you probably remember her if you were a regular listener of my show a couple of years ago. People kept telling me that her Twitter was gone, completely gone, so I went to it. I had it bookmarked and everything since I'm not allowed to follow her since she blocked me. And her Twitter is still there. It still has her picture on it, but she took her last name off, which is something I've been telling her to do for a long time. She finally took my advice, took her last name off of her Twitter, because she was always complaining that she could never get a job, but she had a somewhat unique last name, and it was pretty easy to just type her name into Google, and you would immediately see her Twitter account with all of her just complete insaneness on it. So good for Michelle, I hope that helps her find a job, and I'm sure that she's still making her crazy posts on Twitter, but we just can't see them anymore, because it's private. So what do you guys think of the thing I've been doing lately where I play an old call right at the very beginning of the show? Is that annoying? Do you hate it? I know the first time I did it, there were some complaints about it on YouTube, but the complaints didn't make any sense, so I don't know whether or not to take them seriously. But I've been trying to make two changes lately. One is that I've been putting the prank calls in the very beginning of the show, just old random prank calls. I'm trying not to make them longer than 5 minutes, and I guess I'm doing that just so, I mean, like, listen to this intro. This has got to be boring for new listeners, but I like having an intro with news and just stuff, random stuff about the PLA and the Snowplow show, but for a new listener, that probably sucks. So I put the pranks on the beginning of the show to just kind of give them an idea of what to expect during the show. I hope that makes sense and that's not stupid. If you have an opinion about it, leave it in the comments on YouTube or on phonelosers.org or wherever. And the other change I've been doing recently is I've been putting the voicemails on the very end of the show instead of in the middle of the show. And personally, I kind of like them better in the middle of the show. But what I was noticing on YouTube is that for my hour-long shows, a lot of people, they only listen for 30 minutes. And that's probably because they get bored with the voicemails and shut it off. So I thought I would give this a try and just put them on the end and see if I have longer listening times on YouTube. And speaking of YouTube and really, really long intros that are really boring to new listeners and probably to old ones too, did you know there's other ways to listen to the Snowplow Show besides YouTube? Just recently, I was talking to a longtime listener who always listens by just going to phonelosers.org and clicking on the button. You know, the little HTML5 player. He just clicks on that, and that's how he listens to the show. And I think a lot of people out there, they just do not understand what podcasts are or how easy they make things if you like to listen to this show or other podcasts. So any of you people who are listening on YouTube or you're listening through the website, you should know that there's a much easier way to listen than listening on YouTube, and that's through a podcast app on your phone, on your smartphone. So if you have an Android or an iPhone, here's what you do. You search your app store for a podcast app and download it. The one I use on my Android phone is called Pocket Casts, and it's really awesome. Two words, pocket and then casts, C-A-S-T-S. And there are a lot of other ones if you don't like Pocket Casts. There's Podcast Addict, and on the iPhone, they have their own podcasting app built in, or maybe not built in. I think you still have to download it, but it's an official Apple product, their podcast app. Anyway, get the podcast app and use it to search for the Phone Losers of America or the Snowplow Show. And your phone will alert you as soon as a new show comes out. And you'll never have to go to phonelosers.org again to check and see if there's a new show out or not. And you won't have to go to that stupid YouTube site. You just get a notification on your phone and you hit the button and you're listening to my show. It's really, really easy. And not only that, but you can listen to other shows besides mine. You might find something much cooler than the Snowplow Show and just stop listening to this show. I listen to podcasts every day. My favorites are like Harmontown and Mysterious Universe, Welcome to Night Vale, Distorted View, Star Talk with Neil deGrasse Tyson, and of course all the prank call podcasts that I listen to. But there are a lot of ways to listen to the show. There's also apps called TuneIn and Stitcher. There are links to those on phonelosers.org in the left sidebar. And those are sort of like podcast feeds in a way, but not exactly. But they're kind of awesome. I know a lot of people still listen through those. So spend some time on looking at podcast apps on your smartphone or on your computer even. You can get them through your computer. You can use iTunes or some other program. Okay, now that I've made all of the new listeners tune out, let's get started with the show.
Ho, ho, ho! Santa here! Call 1-900-660-6666, and I'll tell you a different Christmas story every day. But before you call, listen to old Santa. Your parents have to pay for these calls, so get their permission first. Then, when you call me, I'll tell you how to get a whoopee from my Christmas collection. And part of your $1.85 two-minute call goes to Special Olympics. So call me at 1-900-660-6666. Merry Christmas!
I have a fairly large list here from sent in by a listener, a guy by the name of NJB. That's what he signed the email as. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to use his real name. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Mr. NJB, though, he sent me a homeowners association directory that is 2 years out of date, so thanks a lot for that. It's from October of 2014, and he says, for extra credit, I converted this to an Excel file using OCR and PDF conversion technology. So that was nice of him. You know, we all know how much I love spreadsheets. Actually, I'm getting better with spreadsheets since you guys have been sending them to me so often. As long as I can load them into the Google spreadsheet thing and not Microsoft Office spreadsheets, which is a pile of garbage, or I guess I'm just not used to it. But I've found that Google spreadsheets is much easier to deal with than Microsoft. There are several amazing things about this homeowners association directory. Thing number one would be, let me scroll all the way to the bottom. Oh, anyway, thank you for converting this to a spreadsheet, because that's actually more convenient to me than a PDF. Because I can load it into Google Docs and just, you know, make edits. And I definitely need to make edits on this one because this is a really long list. Because as I was saying, thing number one that is really awesome about this is that there are 357 residents in this homeowners association thingy. So assuming that all these numbers or most of them are still good, this is going to be an amazing list. Or, I mean, it's going to last a really long time at least. Thing number two that is very cool about this is that not only is there a home number, but there's a cell phone number. And because there is a full name and an address and a cell phone number, I could use this as a list earlier in the day. I can't do it today, but I could call people on their cell phones and pretend that I'm with Royco Roofing and that I'm currently at their homes and I've torn their roof off And they'll go crazy at me, because I would say probably one-third of all of these people, of these 300 and whatever people in the Homeowners Association, probably, I don't know, maybe a fourth of them have their cell phone numbers listed on this list. So that is a lot of people that I could call while they're at work or wherever they are and pretend to be at their house, tearing off their roof. And I guess that's all the cool things about this list. Anyway, let's give one a call and see what happens. See if it's a disconnected number or if this list is actually good.
Hello?
Hello, Charles?
Yes?
Hey there, it's Roy from the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Yes, Roy?
And I just needed to let you know that starting on Thursday, I guess that's tomorrow, we're going to be beaming microwaves down at your house.
Going to be doing what now?
We're going to be sending microwave beams into your house.
Yeah, for what?
It's just a partnership we have with someone. It's not a big deal. Just don't worry about it. But I'm required by law to let you know. We're going to be sending...
What is the purpose of it, Roy?
I'm not sure exactly. It's we're working with the Chinese government, and they just... I don't know. They want to send microwave beams to your house. Just yours.
I don't understand. I really don't.
You know microwaves? That we use them for communications and cooking popcorn?
Yeah. I mean, I know microwaves that you do cooking and all with.
Yeah. So it's just going to be from Thursday until Tuesday at 3 a.m. is when it's going to stop. 3 a.m.
But I mean, what is the purpose of doing it in the first place?
They're just, I don't know, it's some kind of experimentation. Just, you know, you might want to turn on your air conditioner that day. And it's not a big deal. You don't have to worry about it. It's just the Chinese government, they're using it for, they're just using it for data collection.
What coverage do they have here in Brookstone?
What coverage? What do you mean?
I mean, you said it was to this house only.
Yeah, just your house only. Just your house. They're going to send high-powered microwave beams into your home starting tomorrow.
I know, but I that's what I'm saying, Roy, is what, you know, what is the purpose of it? What does it do?
I don't know.
I
don't know a lot about all that science stuff, you know? Like, I just know they want to send high-powered microwave beams to your house. And do you have any fish, like a fish tank?
No.
Okay, that's fine then. Everything's fine.
But I don't want that to happen unless I know what it's about.
Well, you know, just if you've got a problem with it, you could just leave the house until Tuesday morning.
For me to leave the house?
Yeah. You know, like if you're worried about the microwave beams, I mean, they're harmless. Come on.
Well, but, no, I don't agree.
Really, what do they do to you?
I don't know. I don't know what they do, but yeah. I don't agree that they may be harmless.
Well, I don't think the Chinese government.
You stand in front of a microwave, and they tell you not to do it.
Oh, that's an old wives' tale.
Yeah. Okay.
But it's fine. I don't think the Chinese government would do this if it wasn't safe.
Well, I don't trust the Chinese.
Oh, come on. Come on, don't be racist.
No. I mean, I don't.
Oh, that's a terrible thing to say.
Is it something the government is doing? What is it? I don't want it to be involved in it unless I know what's going on.
It's a very hush-hush program, and we're not allowed to really say much. I'm not giving you a choice, really. I'm just letting you know we're going to be beaming microwaves at your house starting tomorrow at 11 a.m.
And when you say we, who is we?
Well, mostly the Chinese government, because they're the ones with the satellites and the magnification technology. And
who are you with?
I am with the Homeowners Association here at Brookstone.
Who are you employed by?
By the Homeowners Association, and I gave the Chinese permission to do this. It's because you know they're going to share some money with us for letting them do this.
But only one house and our house?
Yeah, just your house for now. They may expand it if things go well.
But what is, Roy, I'm not understanding what the purpose of it is.
I can't tell you. It's a secret.
Well, it's, you know, it's no secret that I don't want it done unless I find out something about it.
Well, you don't have a choice, though, because we signed you up for it, and it's going to happen.
Well, I'm not a member of the association.
Well, that doesn't matter.
You can't sign me up.
You're here on the street, and you're within range of the beams and everything, so it's got to be your house.
Yeah, well, if it's any problem with it, then, you know, the homeowner association will hear from it.
There won't be a problem. Just you might want to turn on your air conditioner first thing tomorrow morning. Turn it up really, really high.
No, I mean, I'm not going to do that.
Well, you will eventually, let me tell you.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm perplexed by this, Roy. I really am. I don't know what's, you know, I don't see how that can be done.
Well,
without my permission.
It's just, you know, it's just money-making stuff. It helps with our expenses.
Well, choose somebody else's house, that it doesn't matter.
Well, no, it has to be yours. Why would you want to do this to someone else if you don't want it done to you? That seems kind of selfish.
Well, someone that doesn't matter to, but it does matter to me.
You're selfish and you're a racist.
Exactly.
You shouldn't be proud of that, being a racist.
I'm not proud of it. I'm just telling you facts. Well,
the Chinese never did anything to you.
Where do you live at, Roy?
I'm over on Bridge Creek.
Now, what part of Brookstone is that? Down around the back road? Mobley Road?
Yeah, somewhere around there. Who knows? Yeah. But anyway, you know, the Chinese government, they never...
You're a member of the association?
Yeah, I'm the treasurer. But I don't see... I mean, the Chinese government, they never did anything to you. Do you have a problem with just Chinese people in general?
I have problem with what you're talking about doing, whether it was Italian, Chinese, United States of America.
Well, now, you said you don't trust the Chinese, so that sounded very...
Well, I don't. As a government, I do not. That doesn't make me a racist.
I'm sure they're good people.
And I resent the fact that you call me that.
Well, I wouldn't call you that if you weren't being such a racist. Hello? All right, we have successfully perplexed Charles. That was actually the real Chinese government experiment, was to see how quickly I could perplex someone. And this is far from being a record, but I'm going to put it on my report here for the Chinese government. I'm going to put it in there anyway, because I think that's some good data I've just collected. And what the hell, he's not with the Homeowners Association? I mean, he's in the directory. Why would they put someone in the directory that's not a part of the Homeowners Association? I don't think I understand that.
Hello?
Hello, Mrs. Murray?
Yes.
Hi, this is Roy from the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just calling to let you know that we're going to be beaming microwaves at your home starting tomorrow morning.
What?
We're going to be beaming microwaves at your home with a very large microwave antenna. We're going to be beaming those directly at your roof, at your house.
Why?
Oh, you know, it's not a big deal. I'm just required by law to let you know. It's an experiment.
I choose not to participate.
Well, you don't have to participate. You don't have to do anything, ma'am. I'm just letting you know we're going to be beaming
I don't understand. Who is this?
Well, just because you don't understand something doesn't mean you have to fear it.
Who is this?
My name is Roy. I'm with the Homeowners Association.
What Homeowners Association?
Brookstone.
Roy who?
Yeah, with the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Roy who?
Whoa, settle down. You're correct. It's Roy who? H-U. But it's just tomorrow morning, starting at 11 a.m., we're going to be beaming microwaves at your house.
Please don't do that.
Why not? What's the problem?
I don't know what it's for. I don't know what you're doing, and we haven't received any information from the homeowners about this.
It's for research, ma'am. It's just research. That's all it is.
Research for what?
We're working with the Chinese government, and for some reason they want to use your address and your address only. They just want to be
my... Okay, who is this? They just, what kind of scam are you running?
A scam? How would this be a scam? What are you talking about?
I think it's somebody playing a joke on me, but, you know, I'm...
Well, is it a scam or a joke? Which one is it?
I don't really know.
Okay, well, I'm just letting you know. I'm not giving you a choice. I'm just letting you know we have to do this. It's for research. We've already taken the money from them, and they're going to be doing it.
You said you're from the Brookstone Homeowners Association?
Yep, that's it.
And you're a member of it?
Correct.
And where do you live?
I live over on Bridge Creek. But anyway, tomorrow morning, 11 a.m., that's when it's going to start. And it will continue for exactly 24 hours, and it will be over by Friday morning at 11 a.m.
Well, I don't understand. My house is the only one?
Yeah, it's just I don't understand all this science stuff. I don't understand. I just know that they're going to be beaming microwaves at your home.
This sounds like some kind of joke.
How would it be? What kind of joke would this be? That doesn't make any sense. Oh, I see. You don't have an answer for that. Imagine.
No, it doesn't make any sense, but, you know, I don't know what to tell you.
Okay, well, I'm just letting you know. Microwave beams at your house tomorrow morning at 11. And if it bothers you, just leave the house. Just go somewhere.
Well, you know what? My husband has had surgery, and I can't just leave.
Why not? You could just go to Walmart and hang out all day.
My husband cannot do that.
Well, you could drive him around or something, right? Just go for a nice drive.
No! Do you not understand English?
Of course I do. I'm speaking English.
We cannot vacate.
Oh, can't you go to a neighbor's house or relative or something?
Hello?
Hi.
Yes, I have a gentleman on the phone that's telling me his name is Roy Hu, H-U.
No, that's me.
And that he will be beaming microwave at my house beginning at 11 a.m. in the morning.
Who are you talking to, ma'am?
He says he's part of the Brookstone Homeowners Association. I've never heard of him, and I don't know. He won't tell me why he's doing it or anything.
Who are you talking to,
he's
ma'am?
He's going to beam microwaves at my house for 24 hours.
Well, that was kind of rude. Didn't even say goodbye. Just kind of trailed off and hung up on me while she's talking to someone else. Probably the Homeowners Association, so this list is pretty much dead now. They're going to warn everyone. They're going to send emails out. Pretty much everyone on this list has an email address. So everyone's going to get a warning. And man, people just are not into this whole microwave beam experiment thing. I don't understand why. What's the big deal? It's just microwaves.
Hello?
Hi, Billy?
Yes.
Hi, this is Roy from the Homeowners Association.
Yes.
And I just need to let you know, we're going to be beaming microwaves at your house. Starting tomorrow morning at 11 a.m.
Okay.
And it's just for an experiment. It's just something we're doing. Just, you know, just a little experiment. Nothing to worry about.
So why is the Homeowners Association beaming microwaves at everybody's house?
Oh, no, not everybody's. Just yours.
Just mine?
Yep, yours only.
Why?
You know, it's just, don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. It's just microwave beams.
So, because I live on top of a hill?
Maybe. Maybe not. I'm not allowed to say. But
So what's your last name?
Who? H-U?
What's your last name?
H-U. Who? Roy Who?
Oh.
No. H-U. Not H-O.
Oh.
No,
just
no.
You. Take me off your calling list.
H-U.
Just take me off your calling list.
It's not
this
a calling
a
list.
Call.
It's not a calling
this is
list.
A prank call.
It is not. What are you talking about? Why would it be a prank call?
Because I'm not. I've never heard of you.
Because you've never heard of me, that means it's a prank call. That makes no sense.
Anyway, just end the call because I'm about to run an error.
Oh,
bye-bye.
Oh, why don't you end the call? You end the call first.
Okay, bye.
Let's try one more microwave beam experiment. See how it goes. I love microwave beam experiments. They're the best.
This is Mark.
Hello, Mark?
Yes.
Hi, this is Roy from the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Yes.
And are you home right now?
I am, but I'm kind of busy.
You're what?
I am, but I'm rather busy at the moment.
Oh, okay. Well, I just needed to let you know that we're currently beaming high-energy microwave signals to your home. We've got them aimed directly at your roof, and we're beaming microwave signals there. And I just need to know if can you go over to your microwave right now? We need to set it up as a receiving station, and you're going to have to put your microwave into test mode, and I'll tell you the code to make that happen. Oh, these people do not appreciate science. You know what? That was not my last one. I'm going to keep at this until I can get someone to put their microwave into test mode. Maybe call it administration mode or something.
Hello?
Hello, Marie?
Yes?
Hey there, this is Roy from the Homeowners Association.
Yeah?
And I just needed to let you know that we're currently beaming microwave radiation at your home.
You're doing and what?
We're sending microwave beams at your house.
I don't need any of that.
Well, no, it's just an experiment. We're sending it from a...
I've got a microwave. I don't need any experiments like that.
Oh, no, these are microwave beams. It's like radio frequencies. We're beaming them at your house right now. Like
Really prefer you didn't.
Well, no, it's not a big deal. We needed to find out if your house is receiving okay. So, could you go over?
I don't want it. Don't beam anything over here like that.
Well, no, it's just you can't see them. They're invisible. They're just, you know.
No, I don't want it. I don't
rays.
Want anything beamed in here
magical
like that.
Magical rays.
I really don't.
But
I really don't.
Okay.
I really don't.
Well, no, we've already started, ma'am. But
well, you just knock it off, okay?
No, ma'am.
Thank you.
This is important. I need your help. Jesus. That lady would not listen to me. And I really want to get someone to go over to their microwave and get them to hit a bunch of buttons. Maybe I could get them to load their microwave with silverware and then turn it on high power. That would be hilarious.
Hello?
Hello, Shirley?
Yes.
Hello, it's Roy. I'm with the Homeowners Association.
Yes.
And I needed to let you know that we're currently sending, we're beaming microwaves at your house. You know,
just what?
The microwave radio frequencies, we're sending them to your house. We're beaming them at your house right now.
Mm-hmm.
And have you noticed anything weird, like maybe with the television reception or fish tanks boiling?
No, who is this?
My name is Roy. I'm with the Homeowners Association. And
okay.
We're beaming microwave.
I haven't noticed anything.
Okay. Could you go over to your microwave? We're going to set it up as a receiving station and see if you can receive my messages.
In the microwave? By the microwave, you mean?
Yeah. It'll be the microwave itself. If all goes well, it'll make it work like a replicator on Star Trek.
Uh-huh.
And we'll be able to just send food into your microwave from space.
From where?
From space, from outer space. We're beaming all this energy at your home from a satellite in space. It's like a $1 billion satellite.
And what home on the space station are you with?
I'm with Brookstone.
This is kind of weird.
No, it's
this is not what it said on my phone when it get in the rain.
Well, I'm calling from my house. I live here in the neighborhood. My name is Roy, but
I understand what you're saying, but it says Southeastern Oxygen Company.
Yeah, that's my home-based business.
Oh.
Yep. But anyway, currently they've dedicated a $1 billion satellite. And they're using it solely to beam microwaves at your house. Your house only.
Why my house only?
It's just an experiment. We just wanted to see if it would work. So if you could go over...
Why gotta be my house?
Why not? Why not?
I don't. I'm just trying to find out because I'm curious to know why I gotta be coming to my house only.
Well,
how was my house chosen?
Well, it's just a random thing, and yours is in a good position to reach the satellites and space and everything.
Well, there are other houses on the side of me. I'm not under, Roy, I'm not being difficult, but I don't understand what's going on.
Okay, well,
and only at my house.
I'm going to show you how to reprogram your microwave, so that it'll accept.
No, I'm not using my microwave right now.
Well,
because I have to replace it, and the metal is coming loose, so I'm not even using my microwave right now.
Oh, do you have a fish tank in the home?
Oh no.
Okay, well that's good. Now, do you have any small pets?
No pets.
What about? Could you go into your bathroom and see if perhaps maybe the toilet water is boiling?
Boy, yeah, I'll go.
Yeah, just make sure. We want to make sure we don't have it turned up too high. We don't want to cook you.
Not only that, but I'm still not understanding what my house, out of all the houses in Brookstone, what my house was chosen.
Your roof, it's a very, very dark colored roof, and that's good for, it reflects the satellite waves.
You know I'm coming back at you saying I don't have the only dark roof in this area, right?
Well, it's a specific shade is what it is, and yours is just perfect for the experiment. So we're beaming all of the microwave energy to your home.
Nothing is boiling.
Is the water warm?
In the toilet?
Yes.
I don't know. I haven't put my hand down in there to see.
Yeah, well, it's clean, right? I mean, there's nothing.
Yeah, it's clean, but I still don't put my hand in the toilet.
Oh, no, it's okay. Just wash your hand immediately after.
No.
It'll just take.
Let me look in another bathroom.
It'll just
boiling.
Okay. It'll just take a second though, and you can put your hand in there and you see if it's warm.
No, I'm not doing that.
Maybe
I'm gonna put my hand in the toilet.
Okay.
I have asthma and stuff. Allergies, and I don't. You know.
Huh? Yeah.
Nothing is boiling.
Oh, in the other bathroom either. Okay. Just maybe stick your face really close to the water, but don't touch it. And just see if you can feel the warm.
I have allergies, asthma, so if it is boiling, I don't know what you got, these microwaves or whatever. I don't want to do that because I have allergy, asthma, sinus.
Yeah, but you're not allergic to water, right?
No, but you said the water is boiling. Why would the water be boiling? Like the microwave and stuff.
Well, I thought we might have had the knobs turned up a little too high, when we beamed it at your house.
Well, I don't know. I still don't understand why it's my house in particular.
I'm not allowed to say because it's kind of a hush-hush experiment. So I can't really say why we used your house.
You asking me for tips in something that you haven't told me anything about, and you just calling me all of a sudden to tell me that my house only has been selected to receive microwaves, and I have no prior knowledge of who you are or anything.
Yeah, but look,
I know what who you say you are.
Mm-hmm.
I have no prior knowledge.
I'll tell you all about the secret experiment if you can just put your finger in the water real quick and
not
let me know if it's
not doing that.
You can
wash it. I don't know what's going on. The water might be too hot. I don't know what's going on. I just don't know what's going on.
Do you have any pets?
I told you I have no pets.
Oh, okay. I was going to say you could stick one of their paws into it or something and see if
If I had a pet, I wouldn't do my pet like that.
Well, just
not knowing
just
what's going on.
Just quickly. It wouldn't hurt.
No, I'm not doing that.
All right. Well, we're going to keep working on this. We're going to keep tuning the dials. And
who is we?
The entity that we're working with.
What entity?
The Chinese government.
I don't know who you are, but I'm going to call the police department.
What? No, don't do that. Why would you do that?
Yes, I am. No, I am going to call the police department because you're trying to get funny with the Chinese government. I don't have time to play games with you, so I'm going to call the police department to see what's going on. I'm going to call them right now.
What do you mean get funny with them? What are you talking about?
When you said the Chinese government, I said, what entity? The Chinese government? I don't play games.
Well, no,
I don't know who you are, and I'm not doing any of the stuff you told me to do, but I am going to call the police because this is strange to me.
You should have the police come over and have them put their hand in the toilet to see if it's warm.
I don't know who you are.
Now,
but you need to get off my phone. I am going to call the police.
Okay, well, ma'am, I'm just a prank caller. You don't need to call the police. I just live here in the neighborhood.
No, I am going to call the police because I don't appreciate this.
Well, I know you don't appreciate it, but it's just a prank call, so why would you bother the police? I'm just a prank caller.
Well,
why
are you calling my house with a prank call?
Here we go again. Why me?
Yes. Why? Yes.
No, it's just a random thing. I looked in the phone book. I'm like, oh, this lady has a hilarious
name.
Well,
I'm going to look in the phone book and call the police.
Well, no, it's an easy number. Hello, police. I just got a prank call, and the guy said it was a prank call, and he only called once. Sorry to waste your time. That lady was awesome. By the way, I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I don't know anything about microwave beams. I keep messing up the terminology. I'm sure nothing I'm saying makes any sense at all. I don't know anything about microwaves. I know how to hit the popcorn button. That's what I use to heat up my generic Tostitos whenever I do the generic Tostitos and Four Loko show. I do know that microwave antennas are used for telecommunications, and that's how a lot of the long-distance traffic is sent across the country. Or it used to be, anyway. Do we still use those? I think we do. I mean, I still see them up on towers everywhere, but maybe they're just lazy and they don't take them down. Oh, and I know that microwaves were invented because there was some technician inside some place, I don't know where, but he was doing some maintenance on some sort of microwave antenna or whatever, and he had a candy bar in his front pocket and it started melting. And they're like, wow, we can cook food really fast with this thing. Oh, and I know that if you jam a pencil into the door handle thing on the microwave and trick it into thinking the door is closed when really it's wide open, and if you turn on the microwave with your face right in front of it, it makes you tired. I don't know why, but don't do that, kids listening at home.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Joshi?
Yes?
Hey there, this is Roy from the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Mm-hmm.
And I just needed to let you know that we're going to be beaming microwaves at your home tomorrow morning from space.
Why?
It's just an experiment. It's just something we're doing. The entity that we're working with, they're paying us a hefty sum of money to beam microwaves at your home.
My home?
Yeah, just your home. No other homes, just yours.
So why I'm not being paid?
Oh, no, because you're just not involved. You don't get the money.
Then why they beam microwave to my home without my permission?
Well, we don't need your permission. We're the homeowners association. We're just going to do
it. Yeah, but no, that's illegal. What? That's totally illegal.
No, it is not.
Because you don't know somebody has heart disease and microwave waves can cause problems.
Oh no, these are low power microwaves, and they're sending them from space.
No, but you cannot do. Homeowner association cannot make this decision without asking the homeowner.
No. Is what they're doing is that they're from very far away. They're sending the microwave.
Right, but still, you made the decision to beam my home without even asking.
But you're not listening.
That's illegal. Totally illegal.
They're sending the microwaves from China, and they're bouncing them off the stratosphere right into your house, and your house just happens to be in the perfect position for them to do that.
Who made that decision and who gave the permission?
Oh, I gave him permission. I gave the
without asking us.
Correct, but I don't have to ask you because you're.
Then you are in totally. I think you are in totally not correct ground.
Oh, you don't even know the law. You don't know how the law works.
Yeah, you don't know the law either.
And you also don't know how microwaves work, because this is completely harmless.
I know very well how microwave works, because I'm a research scientist also.
Oh, so do they still use microwaves for telecommunications to send, phone calls and stuff around the country, or is that old stuff?
They didn't use microwave. That's a different kind of wave.
Well, I know, but there's still microwave antennas, right?
No, that's not microwave antenna.
What are they? What are they called then? Those round cylinder things that you see on towers?
Don't change the arguments.
Okay.
change the arguments.
I didn't mean to change the argument.
Yeah, but you cannot do that. And if it happens, and if something happens, then you are in big trouble.
I'm telling you. You're going to make my listeners think I'm an idiot, because I swear, I think it's microwave. I'm going to have to look this up on Wikipedia.
No, whatever is it, but you gave the permission without asking me. That's the problem.
But it's okay.
That's the problem.
Look,
you have no right it's my private home. It's not. It's in Brookstone, but it's my private home, my private property.
Yeah, but
you have right up to 6 feet of my front yard, but nothing after that.
You're in our homeowners association neighborhood, so we can do anything we want here.
No, you cannot. You cannot. You have only limited rights.
Well, if you say no, we're going to fine you $50.
Okay, try. Right.
Oh, we will. But anyway, the microwaves, they're harmless,
right.
Okay?
Right, and if it happens, then you will not allow us to do it.
You're not going
to... If you find me, try to find me first.
Try to find you?
To find me.
What are you talking
about?
Because
I'm going to take you to court. I know what my rights are.
What do you mean,
so don't threaten me? Okay? Don't threaten me.
Oh, I didn't threaten. What?
That's what you did.
What? Oh,
that's exactly what you did, and I don't want to talk to you anymore.
No, that wasn't a
threat.
Because
you do not represent me
in
this community anymore. Sorry.
Unavoidable consequences.
Sorry, I'm not going to talk to you anymore.
Okay, well, look, I'm just prank calling you, sir. Oh, I guess he didn't get to hear that part. Wow, a research scientist. What are the odds? And he actually seemed to know, but... Hold on, I gotta get on Wikipedia, research microwaves. Okay, here we go. Microwave transmission is the transmission of information or energy by electromagnetic waves, whose wavelengths are measured in small numbers of centimeter. These are called microwaves. This part of the radio spectrum ranges across frequencies of roughly 1 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. Microwaves are widely used for point-to-point communications because their small wavelength allows conveniently sized antennas to direct them in narrow beams. Yeah, see, that's what those cylinder things are on the antennas. They put one on one antenna, they beam it directly to the next antenna, all the way across the country. The high frequency of microwaves gives the microwave band a very large information-carrying capability. Information such as if you were trying to create a Star Trek replicator and you wanted to turn someone's microwave into a receiving station so I could just beam a turkey dinner into their microwave. I think that sounds totally feasible, going by what this Wikipedia says. Microwave radio transmission is commonly used in point-to-point communication systems on the surface of the Earth, in satellite communications, I just made that part up, I didn't know they really had microwaves on satellites, and in deep space radio communications. Other parts of the microwave radio band are used for radars, radio navigation system, sensor systems, and radio astronomy. Oh, look at this, common safety concerns. The common reaction to microwave transmission is one of concern. That sounds right, going by my research today. As microwaves are generally perceived by the public as dangerous forms of radiation. Oh, by the way, I used the word radiation with that lady a couple of calls ago. I didn't mean to do that. I don't want to use the word radiation. I think that would freak people out more than this whole thing already does. Oh, and it's stemming from the fact that they are used in microwave ovens. Citation needed. While high-power microwaves can be painful and dangerous, as in the United States military's active denial system, what the fuck is that? Crap, now I'm going to get lost on Wikipedia. Oh, anyway, it says MPT systems are generally proposed to have only low intensity at the rectenna. Rectenna. Okay, and just quickly before I quit doing this, the active denial system is a non-lethal directed energy weapon developed by the U.S. military designed for area denial, perimeter security, and crowd control. Informally, the weapon is also called the heat ray, since it works by heating the surface of targets, such as the skin of targeted human subjects. Holy crap, the Los Angeles Sheriff's Department announced its intent to use this technology on prisoners. Okay, I'm gonna stop reading Wikipedia. I'll put a link to all this crazy stuff in the show notes so that you guys can learn about microwave transmission and the active denial system. And what was that guy talking about, that microwaves aren't used for telecommunications? I wish he would have talked to me about that, because I don't know what he means by... I mean, I knew that microwave ovens are different than microwave antennas, so maybe that's what he was saying. I don't know shit, though, you guys. I'm just saying the microwave beaming stuff because it sounds hilarious, that's all.
Hello.
Hi, Mr. Brantley.
Speaking.
Hello, it's Roy. I'm with the Homeowners Association here in Brookstone.
Right.
And I just needed to let you know that for the rest of the night tonight, we're going to be beaming microwaves at your backyard. So you should probably just stay out of your backyard for the rest of the night.
What's going on?
We're beaming microwaves at your backyard from space.
Okay. Who are you?
This is Roy. I'm with the Homeowners Association.
Yeah.
And I just...
Okay.
And, just...
Well, what kind of microwave are you sending, Roy?
Microwave, radio frequencies, high energy stuff.
Just my backyard, nobody else's?
Yeah, just your backyard. And if you notice like a weird pattern of your grass turning yellow, it's because of the microwaves.
Are you crazy?
No, not at all, sir. I'm required by law to let you know about this.
Okay, who are you with?
I'm with the Homeowners Association.
You're with the Homeowners Association. Roy, what's your last name, Roy?
Who?
Roy who?
Yep, H-U.
H-U, well... Thank you for calling.
Okay, well, I need to tell you some other things.
What's that?
Can you put aluminum foil over all of the windows that look into the backyard?
No.
Well, you need to. It's very important. It's part of the experiment.
Well, I'm not doing it.
Why not?
Because I got too many windows.
Well, it's not a big deal. I mean, it's not that hard to do. It just takes a minute.
Look, I'm not doing it.
Why not? Because you're lazy?
Yeah.
All right. Well, do you have any pets that go out in the backyard?
Yeah.
Don't let them go out there.
Don't let them go out there.
Yeah,
not going to eat them.
Not tonight.
Not tonight. Okay. I won't let my tiger go out there then.
Okay. If you have a tiger, we're going to be sending you a fine because it's not allowed.
It's not?
Can't have anything larger than a dog.
Well, I do.
Well, you're out of here then, motherfucker.
Well, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for the extra $75 and the fine that I'm going to be able to get from you.
Okay. That'd be good. Roy who? That's okay. I never heard of you, but you must be okay.
Yep. I'm a very important person here at the Homeowners Association.
Okay.
Okay.
Glad you called.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Say goodbye, sir.
What?
Oh, that was great. He's like, what the? Him and his family are going to have so much to talk about tonight. So happy I was able to do that for him.
Hello?
Hello, Judy?
Yes?
Hey, Judy. It's Roy from the Homeowners Association.
Yes?
And I'm just calling to let you know that for the rest of the night tonight, you shouldn't go in your backyard.
Why is that?
Because we're beaming microwave energy into your backyard from space.
Okay.
They're like microwave beams of energy.
Now, is it going to hurt my dogs?
Oh, you should probably have your dogs come in. No, your dogs are fine. I'm just letting you know that, can you cover them in aluminum foil?
No. Have you lost your mind?
No. Why would you say
Hold
that?
Hold on just a minute. I want you to talk to my husband.
Oh, okay. That's probably good. That's probably a good idea.
Hello?
Hi, Mr. Is this Larry?
Yes.
Hey there. I'm calling from the Homeowners Association. This is Roy.
Yes.
And I was just letting your wife know that we're going to be beaming microwaves into your backyard for the rest of the night. And
why are we doing this?
It's just an experiment. It's not a big deal. It's nothing to worry about.
But you are doing that in all neighbor on all back in the whole neighborhood?
Oh no, just your backyard. And
why?
It's an experiment. We're working with some people, and they're sending the microwaves from another country actually, and they're beaming them off of the ionosphere.
Don't put them in my backyard.
Well, no, that's the only place they'll go. That's the only place they can aim them.
You're not going to do it in my backyard, or I'll sue you.
No, we've already started. They're happening right now. If you
you're who? Who are you?
If you need proof, just set a bag of microwave popcorn out there on the picnic table.
Question is, who are you?
My name is Roy. I'm with the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
You are not Roy with Brookstone Homeowners. What's your last name?
My last name is who?
Is who? What?
H-U. Oh, He doesn't like those foreigners. He's going to hang up when he hears a foreigner name. He's like, that's not an American name. Click. I see how it is with the people in this neighborhood.
Hello?
Hi, Mike?
Yes.
Hey there, it's Roy from the Brookstone Homeowners Association.
Hi, Roy.
Hey there. I just needed to let you know that we're beaming microwaves at your backyard tonight, so you probably don't want to go out there.
Well, why are you doing that?
It's just an experiment we're running with the Chinese government. And it's not dangerous or anything. There's nothing to worry about. But just don't go anywhere near your backyard.
Don't go anywhere near my backyard.
Yeah, yeah. And probably stay away from the windows. In fact, do you have any aluminum foil?
No, we don't eat that.
You don't eat aluminum foil?
No. So why are you asking?
Oh, I was going to say maybe you should coat the windows with aluminum foil, but I guess instead of listening to my advice, you're just going to be a smartass and say, we don't eat aluminum foil. Whatever, though. I don't care. I was just letting you know we're beaming microwaves to your backyard from space. From outer space.
Space. Space. Space. Space. Space.
For science. For science. 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 Oh, that's weird. That made him hang up. All right, you guys, I am about done with this. I think I'm going to go for... I really didn't mean to do an entire show of telling people that I was sending microwaves to their house. It just kind of happened. I was just going to do a few of them, and then all of a sudden I couldn't stop. But anyway, I'm going to try just a couple more of these, maybe get one more funny, somewhat funny response, and then I'm done.
Hello?
Hi, Carol?
Uh-huh.
Hey there, it's Roy from the Homeowners Association.
Yes, uh-huh.
And I just needed to let you know that tonight we're going to be beaming microwave energy into your backyard.
Oh?
So you probably just don't want to go out there tonight.
Okay, can I ask why?
It's just an experiment, it's for science. We're just we're beaming microwave energy into your backyard from a satellite in space.
Why?
For science.
Other than for science. I know a little bit about science. Can you give me a little bit more detail?
Science.
Science. Science.
Well, it's with the Chinese government. I'm not sure what they're doing exactly. They're just experimenting, and they're sending the microwave beams into your backyard.
Okay, well, you'll have some reflection in the backyard if you beam anything into my backyard.
Wait, no, don't lay down aluminum foil, ma'am. That'll mess it up.
Okay, well, you're pretty messed up yourself.
What are you talking about, reflection? What are you going to do?
Deflect microwaves from the Chinese.
Don't do that, though, because that'll mess up the experiment and we won't get paid.
Well, you know what? You're not going to eat tonight because you're not going to get paid.
Well, don't do that. Are you going to cover your... Just whatever you do, don't layer your entire yard with aluminum foil.
Definitely it's going to be layered with aluminum foil. Not a problem.
Ma'am, don't do that or we're going to fine you. You're going to get a fine from the Homeowners Association.
Not today.
Oh, yes, you will. If you put aluminum foil in your backyard...
It's my backyard.
You can't do that, though.
I have rights.
You can't do that.
And that's not in the covenants of this homeowners association. So don't worry about it. I'm covered, and you don't have to worry about my fees.
But, ma'am, just don't do it. You're going to mess up the experiment. This is a billion-dollar satellite in space.
Well, you send me the $1 billion, and I won't put my aluminum foil down.
Oh, we're not sending you shit, ma'am. It's not yours. Wow. I'm just going to assume that right now that lady is getting all of her aluminum foil, maybe borrowing some from the neighbors, and she's going to be coating her entire backyard with aluminum foil to deflect the microwave energy. That's great. I'm not going to call back and confirm this. I'm pretty sure that's happening. That's what's happening right now. And I think that's a perfect way to end today's show. Just knowing that lady is going to be rolling aluminum foil over all of her lawn tonight. Just to screw up our experiment, to mess up our science. What a shitty thing to do, you know? Oh, and by end of the show, I actually mean I'm going to play voicemails. Because that's what I'm doing now. It's another experiment. It's another experiment for science. Putting the voicemails on the end of the shows. So that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to listen to some voicemails. And maybe before we listen to the voicemails, I should remind everyone that you should be supporting the show either by promoting the hell out of the show or by making a monthly donation through patreon.com/phonelosers or phonelosers.com/cactus. That would be great. And if you do that, I will guarantee that we will never send microwave beams into your yard or at your house. Your pets will be safe, and you won't have to deal with Wi-Fi interference. So it's a good idea. Support the PLA if you don't want any trouble.
Hey, Roy, it's NY Guy here. And I was listening to the recent Snowplow show, or maybe not the recent one, remember when you did the recent homeowners list on. And I noticed first, kind of like the mid-end of the list, or the second day you did it, that everyone started catching on because the memo was sent out. Well, I have an idea that maybe you can combat that with.
Nice.
Basically,
by the way, you guys, this voicemail is from 5 weeks ago. Today I'm starting with the oldest voicemails and moving forward with them. But this is convenient. He's talking about Homeowners Association, and that's what I've been doing all day.
You should call them, and as soon as they start catching on that it's a prank call, you should try and act as professional as you can. Try and make them, kind of get them on the hook and believe that you're actually with the Homeowners Association, and say that someone hacked the Homeowner Association's email account or whatever, and angry residents sent out the memo saying not to answer the actual Homeowners Association because they were mad with the new regulations that are put in place.
Ah.
Anyway, that might be able to get some people on there.
Yeah.
Maybe it would work.
I'd probably work. Or I could just call them and be like, hey, this is the Homeowners Association. Did you get that email we sent you about those phone calls? Don't believe anyone on the phone.
I'm guessing many people aren't that stupid, but
oh, I'm sure they are.
A few out there that are. Anyway, cactus.
He's gonna call you. He put some senses in your shoes. He's filming in your house today. Your mailbox also looks gay. He's housing refugees on your driveway. He's tearing your roof off all the way. It's the Snowplow Show.
That was beautiful. And look, he left a message right after that. Let's see what this one says.
Hey Brad, it's Dan. I just made you that song. I just want to say I love you.
Aww.
And your shows are awesome.
Thanks.
And you're the best. Love you, honey baby. Bye.
Okay, that's weird. What the hell, though? Why don't you record that song onto, something better than a telephone? Give me an MP3 of that. Maybe I'll actually use it as one of the alternate intros for the show.
Hi, this is Brad from Houston. I was calling in to the Skippy and Dippy Wacky Morning Radio Show. My contest entry, I'm going to have to say the second greatest radio show would be the Snowball Show. I really hope I win those tickets to the competitive cow milking contest. And since I'm on the radio, I just wanted to give a shout-out to my cousin, Nick, from Nick Co. Construction. Go Astros!
Once again, these voicemails I'm playing are from 5 weeks ago, so as you all know, the cow milking contest thing is over, and unfortunately that guy, Brad from Houston, he didn't win. But, you know, keep listening. We have lots of contests around here, and when you hear us play the song of the day, that's your cue to call to win $100.5 on the gerbil. Or something.
Hey, Brad. So here's what you got to do. You got to set up a phone number that dials directly into the phone loser's voice bridge. You know, the voice bridge on the TNI line. You're making prank calls, set your caller ID to that number. And then people can hang out in the voice bridge. And when prank call victims call that number back, they'll be put onto the voice bridge. And then we can fuck with them. And that'll be great.
What a great idea.
So you should do that. Do that, Brad. Bye.
I'll get right on that. That does sound fun, and I can see where that would be useful in certain situations, but I can think of two reasons why I shouldn't do that. Number one would be because of you jerks, you listeners, who would just sit on the voice bridge, and as soon as the prank call victims called in, they would be like, oh, I know who prank called you, it's Brad Carter, here's his address, here's his phone number, call the police on him immediately. And I know most of you wouldn't do that. Most of you are awesome. But there's always a couple people out there that just want to stir shit up, cause problems around here. And then the other reason is just that I like to call from a phone number that makes sense to the person I'm calling, which is usually a local number to the person to get them to pick up their phone. And I doubt my VoiceBridge number would be local to many people that I call. So I'm sorry to poo all over your idea. I do like the idea, and I wish I could do something like that. Maybe I could make that a special event sometime.
Well, dear Brad, this is a pretty fucking awesome idea. And
hey,
I
Corbin
know
guy.
How much you love ideas on the voicemail. So here it is. I really liked the Lost episode, and that was pretty darn good, pulling up the carpet and the floorboards and finding Desmond down there. How about...
I need to do that one again. That was a lot of fun, and I still have the sound effects on my soundboard, so it's crazy not to.
First version of it, you are calling as Desmond... that had been placed in a bunker in...
Yeah, I'll just put on my Scottish accent that I'm so good at.
...the early 80s during the height of the Cold War. And since that period of time, the apartment complex or houses have been built over your only way out.
Yeah.
And you no longer need to push the buttons to do whatever it is for the nuclear dead man switch... Jigger.
That's a great
and
idea.
Can someone come and please?
Kind of like the movie Blast from the Past with Brandon Fraser. Him and his family lived in a bomb shelter, and then they built a cafe on top of it. And somehow the elevator was able to crash through the concrete floor in the cafe, whatever.
Let's jackhammer up this. The floor or tear up the carpet and let you out because you're running out of rations. How's that? Okay. Just a reverse roll on the idea.
Yeah.
Right, bye.
I'm going to do it. Seriously, I think I'm going to do that one. I'll try to remember to do that someday.
Hey, Brad, it's Trucker Chris, man. I'm going through withdrawals in here, man. I'm going north, pound my britches down. I got no new snowplow show. Come on, buddy. Hook a trucker up.
Okay.
Love the last couple of shows, man. Let's hear a new one. Come on. Come on. Blow my air horn for you.
Woo!
Yeah. All right,
great.
Man. See ya.
Thanks for that. I think a new rule for the show is that all truckers who call in have to blow their air horn. You hear me, Stan Trucker? You have to blow your air horn, just like Trucker Chris.
Hey, it's Chris and Sarah again.
Hey, Chris and Sarah.
A couple questions. One, do you remember gold boxes?
Gold boxes?
Gold boxes were a thing, I guess, that you looked into a...
Are you calling from one? Is that why you sound like this?
I don't even remember what they're called anymore. The boxes, you know, the rural little things that stuck up with the phone lines, put a gold box in there, and apparently you could dial into it and make it a dial tone and call from there.
I think that would be called a beige box, wouldn't it? I've heard of a gold box, but I can't think offhand what a gold box was used for.
Anyway, I was wondering if you remember those, if you could explain what those were again, or what they did, if they were a real thing or not.
Let me Google that for you. Wikipedia says, a gold box is a freaking box whose function is to create a bridge between two telephone lines. So it's like a cheese box. I don't think I ever heard them called gold boxes. I think they were called cheese boxes. In its basic operation, the user calls one of the lines, the gold box answers and connects the two lines together, yielding the dial tone of the second line to the user. The user can then place calls from the second line, which are billed and traced to that line. So that was a thing that people illegally did, apparently, in the 60s and 70s, 80s maybe, I don't know. I've definitely heard of that. It was just called a cheese box and not a gold box.
And then I also, not me, this is, I'm sorry, she wanted to know if you could help locate the phone call that had the lady that was a quick washing machine. And I think that maybe Dwight and Carlito had called and then you called and the lady was just real, real upset about the washing machine not working and, you know, all that stuff. Come on, help me out. Sarah's really wanting to know. It's not me.
Oh, yeah, Sarah.
The freaking Sarah.
Sarah, that girl
anyway,
that exists.
Thanks,
well, your phone cut out, so I don't know what you were asking about. Something about a washing machine. And the only call that I can think of that has a washing machine in it is that call that I made to Phyllis, where I told her I was in her basement and got her to jump up and down and sing songs for me next to her washing machine. Is that the one you're talking about? But Carlito and Dwight were not involved with that one, so I don't know for sure. I'll put a link to that one in the show notes, though, just in case. Because that's a really fun call to listen to. That lady was crazy.
Hi, Brad. It's Gloria.
Hey, Gloria. Gloria from 3 weeks ago, by the way. I'm up to 3 weeks now. And I don't know if I'm going to listen to every single voicemail today. Probably not, because there's still 30 of them left. And the voicemail segment's already too long, and the show is already too long. What the hell am I doing? Okay, sorry, Gloria. Go ahead.
I really don't have much to say today. I just wanted to leave a voicemail because I know I've been lagging on that pretty badly.
Yeah.
Yeah. By the way, I know I haven't been listening. I've been listening now for probably, a year or two now, but are you going to do the Snowplow Show forever? Like, forever and ever? Because
probably.
You should.
Why
you should
not?
Be, 80 years old. And still calling people motherfuckers.
Oh, of course.
Because that would be...
I'm never going to stop calling people motherfuckers. Why would I do that?
Genius. And to everyone who keeps asking if I'm going to do that stupid painting, guys, I realized I suck ass. I don't literally suck ass, but I do suck ass at drawing. I'm terrible at art.
What are we talking about?
I made that realization a very long time ago.
Oh, the poster.
So, I will draw it, but, don't judge me when it comes out looking like... an autistic person drew it.
Oh, we're
okay.
Going to judge it.
Well, I love you, Grandma Brad.
You just wait.
Feel better. I'm also sick, too, so we'll just feel better together. Okay, bye.
Hopefully you feel better by now, since that was 3 weeks ago. I know I do. Anyway, I have no idea if I'm going to be doing the Snowplow Show when I'm 80. My guess would be no. I probably won't be, because my average for shows seems to be maybe 3 years before something makes me stop doing that show. But we all know I'll just replace it with some other show that's pretty much exactly the same as this show. Just like I did with PLA Radio and the phone show. Hopefully I'm still broadcasting, 20 or 30 years from now. But that's up to you guys and, the support I get to make all this stuff happen.
Hey, RBCP, it's me, Rusty Shackelford.
Hey, Rusty.
So a little while back, I called your answering machine line, and one of the options is to call VN. I think that's how you pronounced his name in the past. I have no clue what name he goes by or how it's spelled.
Yep.
Anyways, one of the options is to call his home phone. And I've pressed the number for that option before. It just led to endless ringing. So,
well, he's not home all the time, or if it's during the day, he's probably sleeping because he doesn't live in America.
Well, I thought it was some kind of elaborate joke, and there's no way it actually calls VN's home.
Nope.
But sure enough, I tried it again recently, and after 2 minutes of ringing, VN actually picked up.
Holy shit.
Where he is, it was 2 a.m., and I woke him up. He was kind of annoyed. Some stranger called him.
Why would he be annoyed?
But
he told me to set that up.
He was really nice. He was nice enough to talk to me for 2 minutes.
Aw.
One thing that he said that I thought was interesting is that he rarely gets calls from people calling into your answering machine line.
What?
So I felt pretty weird. I was one of the few to actually do it. But
I thought he got calls on that thing all the time. Maybe it's only Legend that calls him.
Anyone's wondering, yes, the answering machine line's option to call VN's home really does go to his home line. And he's a really nice guy. He even said to feel free to call him back sometime so he can tell me about Hacksoring and welcome me to the botnet, whatever that means.
VN's the
best. Also, a real quick question about that. So if we press the option to call VN, will that charge us for long distance? Is that a long distance call that's going to charge us a bunch of money? Let us know. Thanks, Brad.
Since this voicemail's from about 3 weeks ago, I'm sure you've seen the charges on your bill already. But yeah, you probably got charged right around $20, $25 for that call. Maybe $30 or $40. Sorry about that.
Hey, Brad. It's Olga.
Hi, Olga.
I'm just, leaving you a message. I heard that Incognito has Gloria... stuck in a hole. I know all about that hole. And
okay.
I just have one thing
to
say to Gloria as she is stuck miserably in that hole. And all I'd like to tell her...
Oh, because you were kidnapped. I'm sorry. My mind went somewhere else.
In this time of trouble is to see if she can look around for my Kenny Loggins CD. Because I left my Kenny Loggins CD in that hole and I really want it back, so... if she finds it, that would be great. Okay. Bye.
All right. You heard her, Gloria. Olga doesn't want to give you any tips for getting out of there or anything. She just wants to know if you can get her Kenny Loggins CD for her. What a selfish request. All right, last voicemail. And for this one, I'm going to go to the very beginning of the list and play the most recent voicemail.
Hey, Brad. I've been listening to the PLA. Oh, I don't know, maybe 10 years. Never called in.
Loser.
But I just wanted to say, keep doing God's work, son. You make my life complete.
Aw.
And, but hey, you should do more of those police impersonation things, because, you know, that's like, you know,
police
probably the best thing you've ever done.
Police impersonation, and, what?
Yeah, do more of those. Actually, you should call police stations, better yet. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to do it. I'm going to impersonate more police, even though I don't recall doing that. All right, okay, that was a lot of voicemails, and I'm down to just having 22 left, so I no longer feel like I'm behind on voicemails. See, that's one good thing about doing the voicemails on the end of the show. I don't have to feel like I need to hurry the fuck up if it's in the middle of the show. I can just do as many as I want, and it doesn't matter because nobody's listening at this point. Tonight, everyone's homework assignment is to write a 3-page report on microwave transmission technology and how it applies to prank calls. 3 pages, double-spaced, and it's due by Friday. So everyone get to work on that. You definitely don't want to fail my class. You don't want to know what happens if you fail my class. Be sure to follow the PLA at facebook.com/phonelosers, at twitter.com/phonelosers, at both of our YouTube pages, Phone Losers of America and Phone Losers Shows, and my personal YouTube, RBCP. That's an important one. And please, everyone, promote the crap out of this show. Share it in as many places as you possibly can. Personally, I think the best way to spread the word of PLA would be to go to youtube.com/phonelosersofamerica and pick your favorite prank off of there and share it everywhere. Drive your friends and family nuts and just post PLA pranks constantly, all the time. Who cares if they unfriend you? It's all for the greater good. Hey, do you know how many shows I've done now? I have done, after this show, I have done exactly 260 snowplow shows now. And how do I know this? Because yesterday I spent over an hour going through all of the snowplow show files and renaming them all so that they have show numbers. You know, show number one, show number two. I started with the original 2 snowplow shows, which were both video-based shows instead of audio. And I took out all of the extra shows that I had thrown in there in the directory. If you guys downloaded the torrent, you probably know what I'm talking about. I moved those into another directory, though, and I organized everything, and now all of the episodes have an episode number. And I kind of listened to a little bit of those first couple of episodes after those original video episodes. And on the first episode, I didn't even say Snowplow Show. And then the next episode after that one, which I think it would be episode 5 back in May of 2013, on the beginning of the show, I'm like, oh, by the way, I'm calling this the Snowplow Show from now on. I forgot to mention that in the previous show. So I guess we sort of have an anniversary coming up next month. Well, not really, I guess, because technically the Snowplow Show started in 2012, in September, it looks like. But that was a completely different show than what I'm doing right now, more or less. It sort of is, but not really. And I don't know what advantage this has, really, of having the show episodes numbered. Mainly, I was just curious about how many episodes I've done now. Oh, and the cool thing is, I can use those numbers and my handy pocket calculator. And let's see, 2015. The last show in 2015 was episode 238. And the first episode in 2015 was episode 42. So 238 minus 42. 196 episodes in 2015. And that's, I don't know, what the hell am I doing? That's not even interesting. I don't know why I labeled the shows like that, but I'm doing that now. It's done, and that's how it's going to be from now on. So if you look at the show file name on today's episode, you'll notice it's a slightly different format now. And I hope that doesn't piss you guys off, because I know everyone hates change and loves to yell at me about anything that I change around. Anyway, let's stop talking about stupid file names and end the show. Today's show was produced by Buster Darnell and Ben Kilburn. And special thanks goes out to Todd L., Miguel F., and Catbox. And of course, today's show was sponsored by Jeff. It is completely Jeff's fault that I moved the voicemails to the end of the show, and that I'm playing those full prank calls on the beginning of the show, and that I changed the file names around. So thanks a lot for that, Jeff. Thank you for supporting the show so that I have someone to blame everything on. I know it's nowhere near Thanksgiving right now, but since I've been playing this background music throughout the entire episode, it really makes me want to hear Thanksgiving Sucks by Rappy McRapperson, so here it is. Baby clap and pop, tickling the eyes.